Good morning to you, Alan.
Good morning, Julia.
This case has been, I mean, a very cool celeb, certainly, for a number of years now. But it's also a very difficult case. Frankly, I couldn't care less if this woman fell off the side of the planet. I mean, she's as far as I'm concerned, you go off and you leave your country and you go and join a Islamic terrorist group. I want nothing to do with you. However, I'm also the view that she's the responsibility of our country. She's born and bred in our country. She is British and therefore our responsibility. I also don't want her back roaming the streets, being a risk to my fellow and her fellow Britons. It's a really difficult one for a lot of people to get their heads around, isn't it?
Yeah, there are, of course, challenging narratives about this and discussion points. But I think in a sense, it's easier once you start considering certain aspects. Firstly, okay, yes, she was born here, she was raised here, but she did leave here and everyone goes, well, she left as a child, but she, you know, as an adult, she showed no remorse for leaving here, essentially. And she went to join an enemy combatant to this country. It wasn't that she'd gone to France or Germany. She'd decided to join Islamic State that wanted essentially to wage war against her own country. It's a slightly different case to just thinking they went away, They should come back. It's our problem. It's no longer our problem when someone makes a decision and stays wedded to the idea that they are loyal to another ideology and another country.
There's no reason to believe that she has regretted this. As you said, when she was found in the camp and interviewed, she showed no remorse whatsoever. And there's been quite a lot of evidence brought that she actually, she wasn't just some sort of innocent little girl kept at home by her jihadist husband, but that she actually was very much involved in beating, indeed, even other women who did not conform to the Islamist dress code and the like.
Yes, I mean, there have been cases in the past of people who did go, realised very early on they'd made a terrible mistake, this wasn't right, and then spent the rest of their time in ISIS lands regretting having gone. There appears to be none of that occurring in this case at all. She seems to want to compartmentalise this part of her life, forget it happened, essentially, and return now without any remorse and without any sadness for the many victims of ISIS there. What worries me about this case is that, once again, it looks like the justice system is favouring the perpetrators or their accomplices of crimes of genocide and of war crimes, as opposed to the victims. And it's very sad that this should be the case.
Well, indeed. And we know that the British public is, by and large, absolutely horrified by the thought of Shamima Begum returning. We also know the sort of the Twitterati, the intelligentsia, the liberal elite are just sort of saying, no, she must come back and stand trial if she's done anything wrong. Again, I'm really conscious. I don't want her back, but I also don't want her roaming the world. I don't want her free on the streets. The reality is, she comes back to this country, even if she does stand trial, and even if she is convicted of any crimes, difficult to get the proof now anyway, from all those many miles away. The reality is she'll serve maximum a couple of years and then she's free on the streets, and we know she's a risk. And that is the real concern for people. This is about saving British lives at this point.
Well, yes, there's two problems here. The first is that she is just the tip of the iceberg here. There are 150 other cases we've estimated, some of whom have clearly got blood on their actual hands. Some of the worst terrorists would be allowed to come back here and contest the decision to strip them of their citizenship. And that's a huge problem from the security services point of view, particularly if they then end up being let on out on our streets to go forwards. And Shamima Begum herself will become a core celebre for the jihadists, basically. Whether she does or doesn't do anything in the future in this country, she'll be held up as the poster girl for future recruitment drives. Yep. And even if she herself does not do that, she'll be used by others in propaganda. And that's a great problem here.
Absolutely, Dr. Alan Mendoza. Thank you very much indeed from the Henry Jackson Society. We'll watch that case closely. 9:32 is the time.